In 1798, Wolfe Tone accompanied the French invasion of Ireland with the rank of Adjutant General. After its defeat, he was taken in custody to Dublin, illegally court-martialed, and sentenced to death. Rather than accept English justice, he took his own life. This is his address to the military court. Mr. President and gentlemen of the court-martial, I mean not to give you the trouble of bringing judicial proof to convict me legally of having acted in hostility to the government of His Britannic Majesty in Ireland. I admit the fact. From my earliest youth, I have regarded the connection between Ireland and Great Britain as the curse of the Irish nation, and felt convinced that, while it lasted, this country could never be free nor happy. My mind has been confirmed in this opinion by the experience of every succeeding year, and the conclusions which I have drawn from every fact before my eyes. In consequence, I determined to apply all the powers which my individual efforts could move in order to separate the two countries. That Ireland was not able of herself to throw off the yoke, I knew. I therefore sought for aid wherever it was to be found. In honourable poverty, I rejected offers which, to a man in my circumstances, might be considered highly advantageous. I remained faithful to what I thought the cause of my country, and sought in the French Republic an ally to rescue 3 millions of my countrymen. Attached to no party in the French Republic, without interest, without money, without intrigue, the openness and integrity of my views raised me to a high and confidential rank in its armies. I obtained the confidence of the Executive Directory, the approbation of my generals, and I venture to add, the esteem and affection of my brave comrades. When I review these circumstances, I feel a secret and internal consolation, which no reverse of fortune, no sentence in the power of this court to inflict, can ever deprive me of or weaken in any degree. Under the flag of the French Republic, I originally engaged with a view to save and liberate my own country. For that purpose, I have encountered the chances of war among strangers. For that purpose, I have repeatedly braved the terrors of the ocean, covered, as I knew it to be, with the triumphant fleets of that power which it was my glory and my duty to oppose. I have sacrificed all my views in life. I have courted poverty. I have left a beloved wife unprotected and children whom I adored fatherless. After such sacrifices, in a cause which I have always conscientiously considered as the cause of justice and freedom, it is no great effort at this day to add the sacrifice of my life. After a combat nobly sustained, a combat which would have excited the respect and sympathy of a generous enemy, my fate was to become a prisoner. To the eternal disgrace of those who gave the order, I was brought hither in irons like a felon. I mention this for the sake of others. For me, I am indifferent to it. I am aware of the fate which awaits me and scorn equally the tone of complaint and that of supplication. As to the connection between this country and Great Britain, I repeat it. All that has been imputed to me, words, writings, and actions, I here deliberately avow. I have spoken and acted with reflection and on principle, and am ready to meet the consequences. Whatever be the sentence of this court, I am prepared for it. Its members will surely discharge their duty. I shall take care not to be wanting to mine.